Ever heard of a superconducting particle accelerator? Lansing-based company NioWave is one of the only companies in the world that makes them, and the technology could revolutionize mid-Michigan in a very big way. Lindsey Verimus takes us inside the company's new $10 million facility.
Inside a former elementary school, it's not just particles, but science and business colliding.
Industry, private industry, is willing to put real money on the table, and that these devices are no longer just these cool science experiments at the national labs, but they are really viable business opportunities.
Lansing's NioWave, already a world leader in the manufacture of superconducting accelerators like this one, is planning to develop larger, more powerful models in a brand new 15,000 square foot building.
It gives us the opportunity to test in an area that we wouldn't otherwise been able to test.
Accelerators use magnetic fields to crash atoms or subatomic particles together at high speeds. They help researchers learn more about the nature of matter, but have plenty of other applications, including cancer therapy and anti-missile defense.
I don't have to have a magazine full of lots of projectile rounds. It's safer. I have an endless magazine. If threats come into our ships in the future or into our country, frankly, the defense of our nation should be secure with this kind of technology.
The Navy is one of NioWave's biggest customers. It's planning to use the company's technology for high-energy laser lights on its ships.
We need, as a state, to excite people about science, about math, about innovation. That's really what NioWave is all about. It's bringing in new, good-paying jobs, working with Michigan State, science of the future.
We've already added people this year. We're planning on adding another 15 to 25 people by the end of the year.
In Lansing, Lindsey Verimus, Fox 47 News.
And the city of Lansing may be helping NioWave with its growing. The company has requested a 6-year tax abatement with the condition that NioWave adds jobs. A public hearing on the issue is set for July 23rd.